Chapter 6, 1 year earlier, Elixir. May 28, 2010, Karakorum Desert, Turkmenistan. My name is Edward Kelly. The red-haired man with the rat-like face bent forward and reached out his hand to greet Peter. He was enveloped in a cloud of cheap eau de toilette, and Peter guessed that the man was in his late 30s. Reluctantly, he took his hand. Peter Adam. Ellen tore her eyes away from the vast expanse of salt desert glistening underneath them and gave the Englishman a noncommittal smile. Ellen Frank. A pleasure. Are you from Germany? He had to shout as the noise of the huge propeller at the front made it almost impossible to have a conversation. The 30-year-old Antonov An II biplane was filled to capacity. Ill-humored Russian businessmen in ill-fitting suits and Turkmen with huge lambskin hats on their heads were crowded into the 20 or so seats, holding tight to the briefcases in their laps or to huge packages or cages of chickens. Bulging bags blocked the aisle and lurched around threateningly as the plane juddered through the turbulence. The cabin reeked of sweat and oil. The door to the cockpit was wide open, and Peter could see that the pilot was wearing just a sweat-soaked undershirt. His wife, who had been sitting next to him the whole time, began to maneuver herself through the aisle and approached each passenger individually. The passengers answered monosyllabically. Chelikin. Krasnovodsk. Nebit Dag. Despite the fact that Peter didn't speak Russian, he understood that on this flight one had to announce in advance where one wanted to get off, comparable to a rural bus tour. Ellen graced the Englishman with another smile, and then she pulled out her cannon and snapped a few shots at the passengers in the cabin. Once again, Peter admired her for her ability to extract herself from unpleasant conversations without appearing rude. Shortly after their takeoff in Ashgabat, the Englishman had spotted Peter and Ellen in the row across the aisle, and he had been keen to talk to them. Peter was not in the mood for a chat, but he did not want to be impolite, an old weakness of his. "Where are you going?" Kelly asked now. "Nebit Dag." "Hey, me too. What brings you to Turkmenistan? Business or honeymoon?" Peter noticed that Kelly's pale green eyes were scrutinizing him and Ellen as if he were trying to commit even the smallest details to memory. Of course, he was mostly interested in Ellen. When Kelly turned his head to the side, Peter could see that the Englishman had only one ear. What was left of his left ear was just layers of reddish, rubbery scar tissue. "We aren't married," Ellen replied, "and we don't do business either. We do our jobs." Kelly laughed. "Touché," he said. "I did not intend to be intrusive." "We are working for an international news magazine on an article about the Silk Road." "Ah, you were journalists. That's what I was thinking." Kelly pointed to Ellen's camera. "Beautiful camera." "And you, Mr. Kelly?" Peter asked out of mere courtesy. "What brings you into this godforsaken land?" "I am an archaeologist." They were engulfed by hot and dust-filled air as they left the Antonov, shouldering their backpacks. Nebit Dag Airport consisted of a single tarmac runway and a small passenger terminal, which was ripe for demolition. In the distance, one could see the outlines of desolate buildings made from prefabricated slabs. A small town on the edge of the Karakorum Desert rested from the barren soils between the natural gas fields and the Caspian Sea. Peter had gotten rid of the one-eared Englishman by saying some polite nothings. He was happy about that. He wanted to be alone with Ellen. A car was waiting for them in front of the passenger terminal, a battered Toyota with a Turkmen driver who would bring them to their final destination. They had arrived in Ashgabat the day before. They had flown in from Frankfurt via Moscow and spent the night in the Turkmen capital before continuing their trip to Nebit Dag the following morning. Ellen had gotten them the article job and she had planned the entire trip. It wasn't the first time they had worked together, but lately they hadn't been seeing much of each other. Peter was often working away in Rome and Ellen flew around the world with her camera, so Peter was looking forward to spending a full week with her. He was looking forward to seeing her take pictures and to perceiving the world with her special eye for detail. He was looking forward to seeing her for an entire week and feeling her close to him. Turkmenistan was not what he had imagined. What he saw had little to do with desert romanticism or tales from the Arabian Nights. Hundreds of oil pumps were scattered across the land like herds of dull steel dinosaurs. The skeletons of drilling rigs were rusting away amid forests of utility poles and bundles of tattered power lines. Rusty oil tanks.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.